रिस्पेक्टेड चेयर्स, मोस्ट रिस्पेक्टेड डॉक्टर प्रोफेसर पी के गुप्ता जी, डॉक्टर विजय कुमार गहलोत, ऑल द मेंबर्स ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजिंग कमेटी, स्पेशली द्वेंद्र कुमार बिस्वाल, प्रास सुगुनकुल वुरे एंड द प्रेजिडेंट ऑफ बायोक्लूज प्रोफेसर नरहरि शास्त्री एंड द फॉर्मर प्रेजिडेंट्स एंड मोस्ट रिस्पेक्टेड डॉक्टर जयरामन वलाटी. A very good afternoon to all of you, all the dignitaries, as well as all the participants. It's a great privilege for me to be a part of this third INBICS conference as a speaker. I have been associated with INBICS as a core committee member, as a program chairs. But this is a new experience for me, just to share my experience, my research experience, with the diversity of audience here attending this prestigious conference organized by BioClues organization. Being a part of BioClues core committee, I am really honored to be a part of this conference. I will be sharing my views on the topic, the diversity of plant cyclophilins and their status in the wheat genome, and it's very relevant to the session on plant genomics, advances in plant genomics. So just to start with the cyclophilins, why our group is working on cyclophilin, what fascinates us to work on cyclophilins, that has been summarized by us in our recent research article which published in the end of September 2020, just a couple of months ago, in Frontiers of Plant Science, and with the title Plant Cyclophilin, Multifaceted Proteins with Versatile Roles. We have tried our best to compile the information about cyclophilins, particularly related to the plant cyclophilins in this manuscript, in this review article. Okay, so before going further, I just want to summarize what are the cyclophilins and why we are interested in studying cyclophilins in plants. And all of us are aware that amino acids are the basic building block of proteins, and individual amino acids, they are linked together by peptide bonds. And most of the peptide bonds, they prefer to have the trans conformation, but problem arises whenever there is a proline reduce in the amino acid chain, in the peptide chain, because the proline tends to attain cis conformation as compared to trans conformation. However, the trans conformation is important to be for the proper folding of the protein, for the proper functioning of the protein. Therefore, it is very important to somehow convert this cis conformation to the trans conformation. Many of the proteins randomly adopt the trans conformation in the peptide bond preceded by the proline reduce. However, many a majority of the the proteins, they require the intervention of a special type of enzymes, which are called the peptidyl prolyl cis trans isomerases, which we call as the PPIs. PPIs has been categorized into various classes like cyclophilins, FKBPs, FKBCs, parvulins, PP2A activators. Cyclophilins and FKBPs are the two major classes of PPIs, and they also are clubbed into the category called immunophilins, because both of them, they bind to the immunosuppressive drug. Cyclophilins specifically bind to cyclosporin A, while FKBPs, they bind to the FK506 or rapamycin drugs. FKBCs are unique because they possess the domains responsible for binding of cyclosporin A as well as the FKBP. FK506 drugs, so they have the dual function of having the properties of FKBPs as well as cyclophilins. Other two type of PPACs are less common, but they have been playing important role in various aspects of plant cell and function. Okay. This is an overview of cyclophilins, which have been, have been demonstrated, which have been identified in various organisms ranging from E. coli to plants. And I think it's the second table is more elaborate, which gives you the overview of cyclophilins, genes and proteins, and their important properties across the genome in bacterium, fungi, protozoa, animal, and plants. If you see in this diagram, although the cyclophilins have been present in diversity of organisms, almost all organisms they possess cyclophilins, the plant genome has been shown a great expansion in the cyclophilin gene family. And this has been attributed particularly to the recent genome sequencing experiment, which has unraveled various plant genomes, including wheat, rice, cotton, brassica, and so on. There is a large diversity of cyclophilins, in particularly when we talk to plants. In plants, the lowest number of cyclophilins are present, genes are present in Oryza sativa, 29, while the largest number of genes, they are present in Brassica napus, 94. The size of the amino acid is also a variable. If you go for the molecular weight and size, the lowest cyclophilin, the lowest molecular weight is 5.7, while in Brassica napus, while the highest one has been demonstrated, reported in wheat with the weight of around 385 kilo daltons. The PI range also varies a lot, varies from 4.4 to around 12.60 across various plant species. Cyclophilins, they are characterized by a presence of a particular domain, which is called the cyclophilin-like domain. We will discuss the structural aspects of this domain later on. This domain is mainly responsible for the PPIs activity exhibited by various cyclophilins. Apart from these cyclophilins, there are cyclophilin-like domain. There are many of the cyclophilins which possess additional domains, and that's why they are called the multi-domain cyclophilins. So these two tables give the contrasting view of the single domain as well as the multi-domain cyclophilins which are present in various organisms. In addition to the diversity of the domains, we also found that it has also been very well established that the cyclophilins, they are localized to almost all the organelles, all the cellular compartments, whether chloroplast, cytoplasm, mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum, nucleus, and so on. They have been present everywhere. That's why they are ubiquitous in nature. They are ubiquitous in terms of the diversity of the organisms that possess them, and they are also ubiquitous in terms of the type of cellular compartments they reside in. And this is a particular example of the multi-domain cyclophilins, which we have shown a comparative analysis of cyclophilin homologs in Arabidopsis, humans, and yeast. The green shaded boxes, they represent the cyclophilin-like domain, while the other colors, they represent various different type of additional domains which are present in cyclophilins, including TPR, RRM, WD40, U-box, and so on. These domains have been very important in imparting additional functions to the plant cyclophilins that can be attributed to the plant pathogen interactions, seed development, regulation of embryogenesis, plant defense, oxygen signaling, antifungal activity, and so on. I have listed some of the important roles in which cyclophilins have been involved. For example, growth and development in plant, protein folding, hormone signaling, pathogen response, regulation of transcription, and stress adaptation. These are the few of the major roles which I have listed here. particularly want to focus one important role which we have again demonstrated graphically in the paper I mentioned we published in the Frontiers in Plant Science. And this you know, the diagram shows how cyclophilins are important in regulating the auxin response gene, and they you know, try to control how different you know, types of you know, cellular mechanisms they are controlled by the level of auxin. This figure has two compartments. The upper compartment shows the auxin absence of auxin, and the lower compartment shows the presence of auxin. And the important one is the key player in all these mechanisms is the AuxIAA set of proteins. The AuxIAA set of proteins have a characteristic motif called the Degron motif, which has the presence of the important key residues like GP, GWPP, V. We will show how these residues are important because the proline is present here, and that's why the cyclophilins are important in controlling this the expression of the genes. This AuxIAA alone or in combination of the another partner TPIL, they bind to auxin response factors in the absence of auxins, and they actually stop the transcription of the upstream the genes regulated by the ARFs. In the presence of auxin, what happens in that? There is a protein complex. This auxin binds to one of the key member of the protein complex called TIR1, and this TIR1A combination it binds to this AuxIAA at the Degron motif. But this binding is very peculiar in nature. Peculiar in nature means that AuxIAA binds only to this you know, Degron, the TR and IA complex when this Degron motif is having the peptide bond, a particular peptide bond between P and B in trans conformation. Normally it is in cis conformation, but it must be in the trans conformation. This cis to trans isomerization is very important, and that cis to trans isomerization is controlled by a cyclophilin called OSCIP2, which have been identified in Oryza sativa. Once this binding, you know, is there due to this cis to trans isomerization, what happens is that this AuxIAA group of protein, they are ubiquinated and they are degraded by 2S proteasome machinery, and that led to the expression of the auxin responsive gene, including the AuxIAA. So this is a feedback mechanism actually. So this is how the cis to trans isomerization is important, and how cyclophilins are playing important role. These are typical examples showing the importance of cyclophilins. Having said, given you some idea about the importance of cyclophilins, their ubiquitous nature, the diversity of roles they are involved in, now let us come to the second part of this talk, and that's how I titled it at the motivation part two, because we published our work on genome-wide analysis of cyclophilin gene family in wheat, and we also published how there are some of the cyclophilins, they act as heat stress, they act in you know, response to the heat stress in plants. And that was possible only because of the publication of a very complex wheat genome in data 2018. And when we explored the wheat genome for different type of cyclophilins, we found that the wheat cyclophilins in wheat, there are around 83 different cyclophilin genes that encode for 85 different proteins. Actually, 89 proteins were there, but there are four of them were the identical copies we found. Interestingly, in all the 21 wheat chromosomes belonging to the three different wheat genomes, cyclophilins have been distributed in all the genomes, with the maximum number of cyclophilins they were concentrated on the chromosome number 7 in all the three genomes, 7ABD, and the minimum number of cyclophilins were found in the chromosome number 1A, 1B, and 1D. We also find many of the cyclophilins which were duplicated in nature. The different color combination, they show the homologs, cyclophilin homeologs, because VT is a combination of three different genomes. And due to the presence of three different genomes, most of the genes are present at triplicate. That was what we expected in our study. But we also found some surprises. For example, many of the genes, they did not show this triplet trend, but they were either lacking some of the partners or they were having some additional partner due to some duplication events. And the smallest cyclophilin in terms of amino acid range from 160 amino acid, while the largest one having 823 amino acids. So the trend of the variation in PI values we observed in all other cyclophilins, that was evident also in wheat cyclophilins. That additional copies of cyclophilins, in addition to the triplets, they have been attributed to the many duplication events which we showed in form of a circus plot in terms of the segmental duplication, the tandem duplications, and ectopic duplications. We also try to analyze how the intron, how the gene structure of the cyclophilin varies, and very interestingly, we found that there have been a lot of variation in the number of introns in the coding regions as well as in the UTR region. Just as per the table shown here, there were 13 genes which were devoid of introns. They were not having an intron. Interesting, in these 13 genes, there were many of the genes which are duplicated genes which were not having the intron. They were devoid of introns. Eight of the genes were having single introns, while three of the genes were having the maximum number of introns, that is 13, succeeded by six genes which are having 12 introns. Although most of the duplicated introns were devoid of duplicated genes were devoid of introns, but there were some of the genes which are having additional, which are having intron instead of their triplet homologs, and there were also some of the genes which the triplets were having introns, but their duplicated value was devoid of. So that type of variation we observed in terms of the gene structure. We also found a lot of variation in the size of the intron. The smallest intron was having 73 base pair. While the largest intron was having around 28.6 kilo kbs in size. In addition to the introns in the coding region, we also found that there was the evidence of having introns in the 5 prime and 3 prime UTR regions in different wheat genes. As per the subcellular localization, most of the cyclophilins were distributed in cytoplasm and chloroplast, followed by nucleus and the mitochondria, as well as some other organelles. Means almost all the organelles, plant organelles, they showed the presence of different type of cyclophilins, and different number of cyclophilins in them. As we just mentioned in the previous overview of the cyclophilins in various organisms, there many of the cyclophilins, they possess additional domain in addition to the cyclophilin-like domain. In wheat, out of the 85 different cyclophilins, 58 cyclophilins were single domain. They were only consisting of the CLDs. However, there were many cyclophilins, they were having some additional domains, including the classical U-box domain, RRM domain, WD40, TPR. We also found that there are two unique cyclophilins in wheat which were having F-box domain and PAN domain. These domain has not been earlier detected in any of the cyclophilin gene family studied across different genera. These domains have been able to give a different attitude, different functions to these cyclophilins, including involvement in the protein-protein interaction, protein folding, splicing, signal transduction, and so on. We also try to analyze how they are related phylogenetically. Different cyclophilins are related phylogenetically, and what we found that thus in the phylogenetic tree, a trend was shown that cyclophilins, they have been clustered together according to their localization signals as well as according to the domain organizations. Means the cyclophilins which are localized to a particular organelle, for example the red color nuclei, they are clustered together, and also they were clustered together. Additional clustering was done based on whether they are single domain cyclophilins or they are the multi-domain cyclophilins. The cyclophilin domain structurally is actually a very unique domain consisting of 8 beta parallel sheets. They have been intervened by the two important helices, alpha helix 1 and alpha helix 2. And they form a hydrophobic surface on which this the direction of cis to trans isomerization take place. All the Scandi structure elements, they were found to be conserved as depicted by this plot. All the Scandi structure elements, they were shown to be conserved among most of the cyclophilins. We also noticed some of the variations, some of the deletions, insertions in some of the important parts, but most of these variations were limited to the the core structural part of the cyclophilins. In addition to the involvement of cyclophilins in different cellular functions, we also found that many of the cyclophilins, they respond to the redox potential, their response to the oxidation reduction mechanisms in plants. And there are two type of behavior which have been shown in terms of the redox regulation. The one is the direct mechanism in which people have reported that two important cyclophilin cysteine residues, cysteine 122 and cysteine 126, which are very, which are the part of the core, the active site of the cyclophilins, they, when they form the disulfide bond on reduction, they actually, led to the closure of the active site. Very quickly, they led to the closure of active site, and the PPI's activity is lost, just in a fraction of seconds. In addition to this mechanism, some of the cyclophilins has another redox mechanism in which the cis 40 and cis 168, they, when they make hydrogen, they make a disulfide bond between them on particular conditions, they do not immediately lead to the closure of active site, but they lead to the closure of active site through a indirect allosteric mechanism, through a process called divergent loop mechanism. What we found that there is a third category that have been published in one of our previous publications, that TSIP-A1, that is very unique, and that possess both the mechanism, that possess direct mechanism, that possess the indirect mechanisms also. That in that sense, TSIP was unique. So this table also demonstrate the status of different cysteine residues in different cyclophilins. Like the right number of cysteines range from 0 to 7 in different cyclophilins, and it indicate that there may be many other cyclophilins which are controlled by different redox mechanisms in different ways. So these are the figures which show the distribution of different mechanisms. Like the left one shows which have been found in TSIP-17-4. The presence of the direct the residues involved in direct mechanism like cysteine 122 and 126. The right one shows the presence of allosteric mechanism involving C40 and C168. And in the next slide, there have been TSIP-21-1 and 23-2, which are showing both the presence of direct as well as the indirect controlling cysteine residues. Apart from various cellular functions, we were also interested in finding, are there some of the cyclophilins which take part in different stress response in wheat? So we try to generate a heat map of cyclophilins from the gene expression data. whether to know whether there are some of cycloplanes which are involved in heat stress. And what we found that there are some cycloplanes which have been shown a great contribution imparting resistance to resistance or tolerance to heat stress to different plant species, and particularly in wheat. We also did some experimental analysis. We showed experimentally that there are the cycloplanes which are involved in heat stress response, but for the shortage of time, I haven't put that slides in this particular presentation. Just to conclude, we can say that in wheat there are 83 different wheat cycloplanes which encode for 85 different proteins, ranging from 70 to 92 kilodalton in their size. They are distributed all the 21 chromosomes, in addition to the three homologs, the triplet variation trend. We also found that there are some of the cycloplanes which the homologs which are having additional copies, and there are some of the homologs which are devoid of the triplet trend. Cycloplanes are single domain as well multi-domain, and we also found that we found some novel cycloplane domains like FBOX and PAN, which has not been reported in any other cycloplane gene family. CLD is very conserved as a typical feature of the cycloplanes, and cycloplanes have been localized to various organelles. We also did the protein-protein interaction network studies, and also try to understand are there some specific cis-regulatory elements in the upstream region of different cycloplane transcribing genes. And we found many signals which suggest that cycloplanes interact with a variety of proteins controlling different type of cellular functions, and also there are some specific cis regulatory elements which make them specific for the expression during different type of cell response, like hormonal plant pathogen interaction and other such abiotic and biotic stress responses. Having this analysis of this data, we found many candidates which are very interesting in nature, like many of the multi-domain cycloplanes, many of the cycloplanes possessing variation in the cysteine residues, which we are exploring at experimental level to find how they behave in different experimental conditions, how their structures look like, and we are also in a position right now to purify and crystallize some of the multi-domain cycloplanes, so that we can tell to the audience how multi-domain cycloplanes behave in wheat, and that's how in other plant species. So this is what we are planning to do in future. I have summarized some of the future projections, but I will curtail my discussion just to save time. These are some of the publications which we have generated from our different studies in cycloplanes, and this entire work has been a team effort under the leadership of Professor Prabhji Singh, Professor Department of Biotechnology, Guru Nanak Dev University, Amritsar, and my teammates Supreet, Kiran, Mangal, Gundeep, Tanima, Harsimran Kaur, for their help, for their contribution in different aspects of the studies on cycloplanes, and many of the different things we are exploring at lab. These people are playing important role in the experimental, generating experimental data and doing experiments, different type of experiments. This entire studies have been funded by different funding agencies, including DST, International Wheat Genome Sequencing Consortium, Department of Biotechnology for doing the experimental part. So for these reasons, I am thankful to all the contributors, all the different stakeholders, I also thankful to the BioClues organization for giving me this opportunity, and not only this opportunity, was also helping in planning different studies related to the cycloplanes also. And at the end, I'm thankful to my college, Hansraj Mehla Mahavidyalaya, and the DAV College Managing Committee for providing us opportunities to work in such organizations like Viacluse, and also to work with other collaborators to do some to get some insight into the world of plants. And I'm thankful at the last to the organizers, all the organizers of this great conference, INVIX 2020. And with these words, I will stop my presentation, and I will be really happy to, you know, have any queries, have any questions, as well as also having some, you know, suggestions, because the chairperson of this particular theme, they are themselves the stalwarts of plant biotechnology, plant breeding. So I will be happy to get some suggestions from them also. Thank you. Thank you very much.